गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो द एक्सरसाइज 8.1 अप टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 वी हैव डन. सो टुडे वी कंटिन्यू दिस एक्सरसाइज फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. हियर 10, 11, 12 मेनली थ्री क्वेश्चंस आर रिमेन. सो वी हैव टू कंप्लीट दिस थ्री क्वेश्चंस टुडे हियर. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 इज गिवेन. ए बी सी डी इज अ पैरेललोग्राम एंड ए पी एंड सी क्यू आर परपेंडिकुलर्स फ्रॉम वर्टिसेस ए एंड सी ऑन डायगोनल बी डी. So that triangle APB congruent to triangle CQD. And the second question is given here, AP equal to CQ. So first of all, if you see the question is given here, ABCD is a parallelogram and AP and CQ are perpendiculars from the vertices A and C on diagonal BD. So as you see, the figure is given here, ABCD is a parallelogram, and from this A we have to draw a perpendicular, as well as from C we have to draw a perpendicular, and these two perpendiculars are drawn on BD and the points are P and Q respectively. Is it clear? So now here, how can we prove this one? First of all, if you see the triangle, if we consider triangle APB and the second triangle, if we consider CQD, as you see in the figure, if these two triangles are, if we consider APB and CQD, now in both the triangles, if you see the angle ABP and CDQ, these two are alternate interangles. Reason behind, AB is parallel to CD as well as BD is the transversal. For that reason, here we can write ABP is equal with CDQ, alternate interior angles. Secondly, here AB equal to CD. If you see here, AB and CD are equal. Reason behind, because it is a parallelogram, and in case of parallelogram, opposite sides are always equal, parallel, we know. And thirdly, if you see angle APB, APB is equal with CQD. Reason behind, the angles are here perpendicular we draw, so that's why the angles are here 90 degree. So now here two angles and one side we get equal, so from here we can write by angle side angle congruence rule, easily we can say these two triangles are congruent, and these two triangle means triangle APB congruent to triangle CQD. So from the congruence property, angle side angle, easily we can say these two triangles are congruent. If two triangles are congruent, then by CPCT their corresponding parts are also equal. That means the corresponding part means the perpendicular lines which two are AP and CQ. So this AP and CQ are also equal. So these two are the proof we need here. So already we have done this one. So after that, now if you see the question number 11. So the question number 11 is given here, in triangle ABC and DEF, in triangle ABC and DEF, AB equal to DE, as well as AB is parallel to DE, and BC is equal to EF, and BC is parallel to EF. Vertices A, B and C are joined to the vertices DEF respectively, as shown in figure. And here we need to prove six question here. First one is quadrilateral ABED is a parallelogram. Second one, BEFC is a parallelogram. Third one, AD parallel to CF, as well as AD equal to CF, we need to prove. Fourth one is ACFD is a parallelogram, we need to prove. Fifth one is AC equal to DF, we need to prove, as well as the last one is we need to prove triangle ABC congruent to triangle DEF. So for that reason, first of all here, if you see the diagram properly, first of all we draw two triangles ABC and DEF, and then we join A to D and join B to E and join C to F, as well as here the question is already mentioned, AB is parallel to D, AB is equal to D, and as well as AB is parallel to D. So now from here, if we start here, the first one is how can we write, let's see. So in quadrilateral ABED, as you see the diagram here, in quadrilateral ABED, already given AB is equal to DE, isn't it? And here AB is parallel to DE already given. So we know the property of parallelogram. If one side is equal and parallel, then easily we can say it is what? A parallelogram. So from here easily we can see ABED is a parallelogram. As you see, the condition is also written here, one pair of opposite sides is parallel and equal. Similarly, the second one we can prove, BEFC, same thing, BC equal to EF and BC is parallel to EF. So again, one pair of opposite side is parallel and equal. For that reason we can say here BEFC is parallel. So now the third one is, you see here, BE equal to CF and BE equal to CF parallel here. So already we know BEFC is a parallelogram as well as ABED is a parallelogram, isn't it? If these two are parallelogram, then easily we can say from these two, if we combine, then AD equal to CF and AD is parallel to CF, easily we can write. So number four, ACFD is a parallelogram. If ACFD is a parallelogram, then their opposite sides are equal and parallel. So from there we can say AC equal to DF. Similarly, the sixth one is what? In triangle ABC and DEF, two triangles are withdrawn. So there AB equal to DE already given, BC equal to EF already given. And from the first two, we prove AC equal to DF, isn't it? So all three sides are equal. From here what we can say, by side congruence rule, these two triangles are congruent. Is it clear? So these six proofs are easily we have done here. So the next question is question number 12. If you see the question number 12, ABCD is a trapezium in which AB parallel to CD. So what is the property of trapezium? Opposite sides are parallel, isn't it? So here written AB is parallel to CD already given and AD equal to BC. So if we take these two and we need to prove here angle A equal to angle B, angle C equal to angle D, and ABC congruent to BAD, as well as diagonal AC equal to diagonal BD, we need to prove. So in this trapezium, what you have to do is little bit a construction we need to do. So what you have to do, we join AC as well as we join BD. As you see here in this figure, we join AC and BD, and extend AB and draw a line through C parallel to DA. So we have to extend the line AB, and then after that we have to do through C, we have to draw a parallel line, and this line is parallel to AD. And when we draw this line intersect at one place of this extended AB, and this point is we denoted by E. Is it clear? So now you see the proof. Since AB is parallel to DC, if AB is parallel to DC, so A is also parallel to DC, we can write, isn't it? Because we extend the AB line, so A is parallel to DC and AD is parallel to CE. So now here opposite sides are parallel, so that's what we can say here, ADCE is a parallelogram. Opposite sides of pairs of sides are parallel. So now if we know here the consecutive interangles, that means linear pair, you know the consecutive interangles, the sum of consecutive interangles are what? 180 degrees. So that's why we write angle A equal plus angle E equal to 180 degree, as well as we write here, you see, angle B plus angle C B equal to 180 degree. So AD equal to CE here, AD equal to BC, BC equal to CE. So angle E equal to, easily we can write here CBE from the given figure. Similarly, angle B plus angle E equal to 180 degree, same condition, consecutive interangles. So from here we write these four equations, whatever we write, 3 and 8. If you see the equation 3 and 8, if you compare this to angle A plus angle E equal to angle B plus angle E, reason behind, both are 180 degree, and from here if we compare, angle E is cancelled with angle E, so that's why angle A equal to angle B. Similarly, the second one is angle A plus D equal to 180, B plus C equal to 180. So if you compare these two, same thing we get here, angle C equal to angle D. And the third one is here, in triangle ABC and BAD, AD equal to BC given, angle A equal to angle B already we proved, and AB equal to CD are the common in the given figure. So by angle side angle congruence rule, these two triangles are congruent. So if two triangles are congruent by CPCT, their corresponding parts are also equal. So that's why here diagonal AC is equal with diagonal BD. Is it clear? So today here we complete question number 10, question number 11 and question number 12. So you have to copy these three questions properly, or if any doubts are there, then you can ask me. So in our next class, we have to continue the exercise, the second one. The second exercise is 8.2. So before this 8.2, if some theoretical parts are there, so we have to discuss this part first and then we continue the exercise 8.2. Is it clear? Okay, thank you.